Hey, it's your boy Tim Leak, all the iPhones cook. Today we're going to be taking a look at the latest and greatest from China. This is the Gufone 11 Pro, our latest device, and we've added an entirely new camera. It's a new system, and by my calculations, should be the best iPhone yet. So we've been working on this hard. Everyone's been leaking this. It's just frustrating. Let's go ahead and take a look at what they've delivered to us. And this is supposed to be the latest and greatest version with all of our latest camera advancements and the actual look. So we'll see how close they got. Now, mind you, these guys have never, oh, down my shirt again. All right, put him back to bed. Now, mind you, when making this, these guys have never seen the actual iPhone 11. So whatever's in here is a mystery to them and a mystery to me. Supposedly though, it's the accurate version with all the leaks considered. And of course, I have their previous Gufone XI to compare with, the official iPhone XS Max packaging. Let's see how these compare. So they seem to think that Apple is going to continue to use a space-themed wallpaper. This is a pixelated version of Pluto. I can see the JPEG jagged edges there, but I like that they put an effort into it at least. And the actual packaging is now synonymous with that of Apple's. So the last one was really crappy. This is a thick plastic. They're definitely upgrading in at least one way or another. And they have that little green arrow there. So kind of cool, attention to detail. I'm hoping that they follow through on the software side too, that this is running some sort of version of iOS 13. And there it is. Definitely a better presentation than the last one here. It comes preloaded with a screen protector. And let's see. Oh, there it is. So as you can see, this actually follows the rumors quite nicely. And from what I'm seeing, there's an actual sheen on the back of glass. Very, very similar to that of the XS Max, but still slightly different. Very cool. Okay, so let's take a look at this lens. It's interesting. So it does have a run-up. So it seems that the lens and the back glass are almost one solid piece, but there is a break between it. And overall, it looks really good. From everything that we've been rendering and seeing online in leaks, this is probably the best interpretation of that in the physical sense. Although I'm disappointed the Apple logo here is towards the top. So after thinking about that for a while, I can kind of understand why Apple's lowering it. When you have such a big lens, you want to give this some breathing space. And what better way to do it than by dropping it down, getting rid of the iPhone text, and giving people a place to put their new AirPods 2 to charge on the back of the iPhone 11 Pro. But there it is, looks pretty interesting. Gotta say, it'll definitely grow on you. I've never minded this design, a lot of people dislike it, but I think it looks cool. And weight-wise, feels just about the same as the XS Max. So just by that alone, I wouldn't be able to tell the difference. And there's that lens. So quite a difference, absolutely huge. And the actual individual lenses do protrude. And the flash unit has this weird divot around it. Cool. Anyways, let's boot it up and see what they got running on it. Usually it's iOS 12 on the last version of their initial iPhone 11 clone. But these things have gotten so complex over the years. I mean, you wish that your iPhone clone a few years ago had an actual notch and a screen this big. The amount of value you get for the money nowadays is crazy. But then again, it is still theft and this is illegal. It's kind of amazing how they're still able to get away with it nowadays. And we got a globe wallpaper here, matching that on the packaging of the 11 Pro. Swipe inside and there it is. All right, so I'm excited to check out iOS 13 or 13.1 by release. Let's see what we got on here. 12.1.1, all right. Well, theoretically you should be able to jailbreak. We got 256 gigabytes, even though the packaging said 512. They wouldn't lie now, would they? The back swipe does work. Cool. So looks like they did upgrade the software. This is different than the first initial version, or no way would it be that one right here. So before you could not swipe it back in settings, and that is so frustrating when you've been using an iPhone for so long. It's like, what makes an iPhone? Otherwise, the text inside looks a little off comparing it to the real deal. Of course, it likely does not have dark mode. Yeah, so Control Center. Oh, Control Center now comes with a 3D touch toggle. The last one did not. And there's True Tone. Wow. Okay, that's cool. So the first clone did not have True Tone or Night Shift here. That's the Night Shift icon. And the volume platter can be 3D touched. They got the glyphs wrong. but it looks pretty dang close over here. You cannot 3D touch that, and the player, you cannot 3D touch that. So fairly close, but there is a difference in some ways, of course, and it's not a separate page. So on the last version, it was a separate page that slid down. Here, there's a little bit better attention to detail. What else? What kind of wallpapers does it have? So all of the XS wallpapers, including the live ones, which do not work. Yeah, that's just a static image. So it doesn't go too in detail, but it does have this new one mimicking that of supposedly the 11 Pro. We'll see what wallpapers Apple drops. Supposedly supposed to be some good ones here. Oh, and some very interesting interpretations of Apple's settings. Emergency SOS is fake, doesn't even open. Face ID. Let's take a look at that. Okay. Oh, look at those pixels. Oh my goodness, that is so bad. Okay, so very, very terrible front-facing camera. And move your head slowly. Even if I don't move it, it still completes the sequence. Okay, face ID scan complete. So let's see if it actually works with my face. And it has no dialogue, no menu for face ID. And doesn't want to work. Doesn't want to scan. Yeah, so it looks like the face ID feature might be a bust. Even the passcode screen doesn't have the original wallpaper on it behind it. Other than that, let's see what else they got right. So widgets page, fairly responsive. We got spotlight search. Let's check out the app switcher. Oh, there it is. All right. So a swipe up seems to work. Does the navigation or gesture control work? That it does not. So none of these clones can seem to get the gesture control right. You actually have to swipe up and then go to the different app. You can live with that. Not bad for what, $110, $100, not too bad. And I do wonder if tap to wake works. Oh, it does. Cool. So you do have a tap to wake feature here. It's not with one tap, it's with two taps. But they did implement that. That's very nice to see. So someone put actual attention to detail in here. And the flash does work. Oh my goodness. Every time I turn it around, that's like a shock in your face, all those cameras. And we've got the cover sheet. So seems to tick all the boxes software-wise. It's not running iOS 13, which you'd expect it to, but at least they upgraded it over to the last version and it's a lot more responsive now. So this is better than this one in every way. I actually wonder if it'll fit Pitaka's case, if the lens placement is actually correct. Oh, wow. And look at that. It is. So these guys have actually went off the leaked schematics, aside from lowering the buttons, which they're all lower on the new one. They kept them the same. Other than that, the lens placement is correct. And on the bottom, the speaker ports are correct versus the XS Max. Who knows if they'll be different on the new one. All the menus seem accurate. Wait a minute. Home button. We have a home button here. Press the home button to try it. Definitely trying that one. All right, let's get a closer look at this bunny. Seems to think that we can't see it. So the XS Max can make out details. On the 11 Pro, you'd think with all those cameras, it'd do a little bit better, but it looks like a ghost just blending in. As for colors, let's take a look at those. And we're very pixelated on the 11 Pro. Very disappointed in the triple lenses and very disappointed in the Panasonic S1 Focus. What a letdown. Dynamic range, non-existent. Look at that transition, beautiful. All right, so not what I thought. You know, I really thought that this thing would be better. Time to go back and make some changes. Hopefully in 4 days, we'll see the real deal. All right, guys, obviously it's a joke. This will be the best camera ever on the iPhone. You cannot compare this as only the top one here is the real one. The rest are duds. Okay, cool. So we've established that cameras suck. I definitely think this design will grow on us. After you upgrade, you'll wonder how you lived with an iPhone without an ultra-wide lens. Even though it may not look very savory, you'll definitely learn to love it with time, just based on the functionality. And this gives us a pretty good preview, besides the placement of the Apple logo, of how it'll look. The closest look at the design so far. And I think I'm gonna break the screen if I try and remove it, as something happened. Okay, so it looks like the screws aren't even attached to the screen to begin with. Okay, so it's weirdly glued in up here. And the internals are different versus the last one. They're using a different type of PCB. And that's the battery shielding, cast metal all around to give it a appearance of heft. And I've unplugged this from the bottom. So unless I do some surgery, we'll not be able to replug that easily. Dual SIM is standard now, seemingly on all clones. So they've cloned Apple's stack dual SIM orientation. And in a few days, we'll be adding the real deal here to my timeline, freshly renovated. From the very beginning with the iTunes phones to the latest iPhone 11 Pro Max. Cool. So that's the actual lens type versus the dummies we saw before. And of course, the proper Apple logo placement. And then we left some space here for the 2020 iPhones. We'll be extending it, of course, with time. All right, man, look at that. Got to get the color matching right here, but I think it looks super cool. And of course, all of them to have the glowing logo eventually. I always enjoy checking out these clones. We'll see the next version after the release, but guys, just a few more days. I cannot wait to see the iPhone 11 Pro. Hope you enjoyed the video. Peace.